प्रॉब्लम नंबर सिक्स। एक्सरसाइज 13.3 प्रॉब्लम नंबर सिक्स। प्रॉब्लम बेस्ड ऑन द बेस थ्योरम। देर आर थ्री कॉइन्स। वन इज ए टू हेडेड कॉइन। टू हेडेड मीन्स हैविंग हेड ऑन बोथ साइड फेसेस। अनदर इज बायस्ड कॉइन दैट कम्स अप हेड्स 75% ऑफ द टाइम। एंड द थर्ड वन इज अनबायस्ड कॉइन दैट मीन्स प्रॉबिलिटी ऑफ गेटिंग हेड इज हाफ एंड प्रॉबिलिटी ऑफ गेटिंग इज टाइल। इन द बायस्ड कॉइन द प्रॉबिलिटी ऑफ गेटिंग हेड इज 75% means 75/100 and getting tile is 25/100, it is not 50-50%. Such coin is said to be biased coin. One of the three coins is chosen at random and tossed. It shows head. What is the probability that it was two-headed coin? So once he knows that he got head, whenever he tossed a coin by choosing out of the three given coins, the probability that the chosen coin is two-headed coin. That is the problem here. So let E1 stands for the first event. Event of choosing or tossing two-headed coin. E2 stands for event of choosing biased coin. Biased coin. And E3 stands for event of choosing unbiased coin. Unbiased coin. And H stands for ultimately getting off head. Getting off head whenever the chosen coin is tossed. Whenever the randomly chosen coin is tossed. Getting off head. Randomly chosen coin is tossed. These are the events in our experiment. So, probability of choosing the coin even. is 1 by 3. Out of 3 coins, one may be chosen in one way only, hence 1 by 3. Similarly, probability of choosing the coin E2 is also 1 by 3. Probability of choosing the coin, biased coin, is also 1 by 3. Now, probability of event, conditional event, H over E1. That means conditional probability of getting head. Whenever the first two-headed coin is chosen and it was tossed. Once two-headed coin is tossed, the probability of getting head is only 1. Similarly, probability of getting head whenever the unbiased coin is tossed, that is given 75/100. In 75% cases, it gives us the head. This is also given value. And probability of getting head whenever we choose the third coin is 1/2, because it is unbiased coin. The chance of getting head on the unbiased coin is only 1/2. So based on this, we have to find the probability of choosing two-headed coin once we know that or given that head appears on the tossed coin. Now required probability. The required probability is probability of happening of even on the occurrence of heads. Once we know that head appears on the tossed coin, conditional probability of event of choosing two-headed coin. That is probability of even intersection H by probability of H itself. But probability of even intersection H by multiplication theorem, probability of even into probability of H on the occurrence of even. This is prior event and this is posterior event. Before getting head, one should choose the coin. Hence, probability of even into probability of head on the occurrence of even is probability of happening of both even and H. By probability of H, probability of H may be associated, H may be obtained either this one is total probability. I will write like this. Probability here, probability of H may be considered like this. H may be happened in association with E1 or in association with E2 or in association with E3. The totally head obtained by choosing the two-headed coin or biased coin or unbiased coin. So probability of getting head may be happened by happening of this event or this event or this event. That means H is associated with either E1. H may be associated with E2. H may be associated with E3. All the possibilities to be considered here. So probability of E1 intersection H is probability of E1 into probability of H on the occurrence of E1 by similarly in the denominator probability of E1 into probability of H on the occurrence of E1 by multiplication theorem. Probability of E2 into probability of H on the occurrence of E2 plus probability of E3 into probability of H on the occurrence of E3. Okay. This is total probability of getting head. So, all the values are here. Probability of E1 is 1 by 3. Choosing of two-headed coin. And probability of getting head once we choose this two-headed coin is 1 by 1 by 3 into 1 plus this is also 1 by 3 into probability of getting head once biased coin is chosen 75 by 100. 75 by 100 is 3 by 4 plus 1 by 3 into this is 1 by 2. You can remove 1 by 3 by taking 1 by 3 common, you can remove 1 by 3. So 1 by 1 plus 3 by 4 plus 1 by 2. On simplification, 4 is our LCM in the denominator. So 4 plus 3, 7 plus 2, 9. So the required probability is 4 by 9. Hence, the required probability of getting head once we know that we get a head on the tossed coin, the probability that the chosen coin is two-headed coin. This is the way of applying Bayes' theorem. Next one. Problem number 7. In exercise 13.3, problem number 7. An insurance company insured 200 scooter drivers, 400 car drivers, and 600 truck drivers. An insurance company insured 2000 scooter drivers, 4000 car drivers, 6000 truck drivers. The probability of accidents are 0.01, 0.03 and 0.15 respectively of these scooterists or car drivers or truck driver or insured persons respectively. One of the insured person meet with an accident. We know that one of the insured person meets with an accident. What is the probability that he must be a scooterist? So, okay, let A be the event of choosing an insured person. Insured person. E1 stands for choosing of a scooter driver. Insured, choosing of an insured scooter driver. E2 stands for choosing of an insured car driver. E3, choosing of an insured truck driver. Let us suppose A stands for choosing of an insured person, either scooterist or car driver or truck driver. So, A may be associated either with E1 or E2 or E3. Once we know that it was happened, okay, an accident, one of the, accidents, choosing, event of choosing an insured person who met accident. Okay. A stands for event of choosing an insured person who met accident. So, it may be a scooter driver, or it may be a car driver, or it may be a truck driver who met the accident. Now, probability of choosing an insured scooter driver. Here the number of scooter drivers are 2000 and the total number of insured persons are 2000 plus 4000 plus 6000. So this is 2000 by 2000 plus 4000 plus 6000. So this is 2 by 12. Probability of E2, choosing of an insured car driver, out of total 12,000 insured persons, 4000 are car drivers. Hence, probability of choosing an insured car driver is 4000 by 12,000. This is 4 by 12. And probability of E3 is 6000. Out of 6000 truck drivers, one is selected in 6000 C1. And the total number of insured persons are 12,000. So, 6000 by 12,000. This is 6 by 12. 1 by 2. Again, here probability of A on the occurrence of E1. Probability of A on the occurrence of E1. That is given, the scooterist probability that a scooterist met accident is 0.01. This is given. Here given. Here given. Probability of a scooterist to meet an accident is 0.01. Probability of a car driver to meet an accident is 0.03. And probability of car driver to meet an accident is 0.03 and truck driver is 0.15 respectively. These are the values given to us. Now, based on these probabilities and the probability of choosing a person, either scooterist or car driver or truck driver, we have to find the probability that a randomly selected insured person, once he met an accident, we know that he met an accident, what is the probability that he is a scooterist? That means conditional probability of happening of E1 on the occurrence of E. That means once the accident is met by a person, insured person, that he should be a scooterist. Probability of E1 on the occurrence of A. So that is probability of E1 intersection A by probability of A. But probability of A may be associated with either E1 or E2 or E3. In all these cases, the person may met the accident. So that by multiplication theorem of probability, probability of E1, just this is conditional probability definition, just I am analyzing the terms. This is total probability of P of A. So by using multiplication theorem, this is probability of E into probability of A on the occurrence of E1 by probability of E1 into probability of A on the occurrence of E1 plus probability of E2 into probability of A on the occurrence of E2, probability of E3 into probability of A on the occurrence of E3. So these are all the probabilities by using these probabilities, you can get the required probability. So the required probability is probability of E1 choosing an insured scooter driver is 2 by 12 into the corresponding probability of a scooterist to meet an accident is 0.01. Similarly, in the denominator, we get 2 by 12 into 0.01 plus 4 by 12 into 0.03 plus 6 by 12 into 0.15. Okay. On taking 1 by 12 common and cancellation of 1 by 12 in the numerator, we get 2 into 0.01 by 2 into 0.01 plus 4 into 0.03 plus 6 into 0.15, which is nothing but 2 by removing the decimals here, because decimal values after a point we have two decimal places in each term, hence you can remove the decimals. You get 2 into 1, 2, 1, 2 plus 12 plus this is 90. This is 90. Hence we get 2 by this one is 14. 14 means 104, which is 1 by 58. 1 by 58 is the required probability. You have to apply the Bayes theorem in such a way. By this is the concept of Bayes theorem, generalized multiplication theorem. Generalized multiplication theorem is called Bayes theorem. Next one. Eighth problem. Eighth problem related to exercise 13.3. A factory has two machines, A and B. Past record shows that machine A produced 60% of the items of output, and machine B produced 40% of the items. Further, 2% of items produced by machine A and 1% produced by machine B were defective. All of the items are put into one stock pile, and then one item is chosen at random from this and is found to be defective. If one item is selected at random from the produced items, if it is found to be defective, what is the probability that it was produced by machine B? Here, there is machine A and machine B. Machine A produces 60% of the items. In which 2% of items are? Defective. Machine B produces 40% of items. 40% of items in which only 1% items are defective. Okay. Once you consider 100%. 100 items are produced by both A and B. Out of 100, 60 are produced by A, and in which 2 are defective. Per 100. Similarly, if 40 are produced by machine B out of 100, in which 1% out of 40, 1% items are defective. So these are all the probabilities. These are the given data related to the machine A and machine B. Once an item is selected at random that was produced by both A and B, either A or B, one item is selected at random. For sample, one item is taken, and it is found to be defective, then what is the probability that it was produced by machine B. Okay. Let E1 stands for selection of item produced by item produced by machine A. E2 stands for event of selection of item produced by machine B, and D stands for event of selection of a defective item. once randomly an item is picked up from total stock pie produced by both A and B, it is found that it is a defective item. Hence D stands for event of selection of a defective item. Then the probability of happening of event, probability of selection of an item produced by machine. Out of 100, 60 are produced by A. Hence, the probability of selection of an item produced by machine A is 60/100. Probability of selection of an item produced by machine B is 40/100. And probability of D on the occurrence of even. D over even is an event, conditional event of selection of a defective item produced by machine. That is 2%. So 2/100. And probability of D on the occurrence of it, that is 1/100. So with the help of these probabilities, now the required probability is, once D was happened, the item is selected from machine B is needed here. Hence, probability of E2 on the occurrence of D itself. So by definition of conditional probability, that is by definition of conditional probability, probability of E2 on the occurrence of D is probability of E2 intersection D by probability of D. But probability D happened in association with either E1 or E2. Hence, this is nothing but probability of E1 intersection D or probability of E2 intersection D. Probability of E1 intersection D is probability of E2 before selection of defective item, the machine should be selected. So, the probability of the item is taken from either E1 or E2. Hence, probability of E2 into probability of D on the occurrence of E2. Why? Similarly, probability of E1 into probability of D on the occurrence of E1 plus probability of E2 into probability of D on the occurrence of E2. It may happen or it may happen. Before selection of defective item, the item to be produced, either machine A or machine B. Hence, we have to consider both the possibilities. So, probability of E2. What is the probability of E2 here? 40/100. Correspondingly, selection of defective item produced by machine B is 1/100. By this is 60/100 into corresponding selection of defective item is 2/100. Similarly, 40/100 into this is 1/100. These are the total possibilities. Out of this total possibilities, this is favorable possibilities to this event. So, which is nothing but 40/120 plus 40. 40/160. This is 1/4. The required probability is 1/4. Okay. Next problem number 9 of this exercise. Two groups are competent for the position of the board of directors of a corporation. the probabilities that the first and second groups will win for the position of board directors or respectively 0.6 and 0.4. Further, if the first group wins, the probability of introducing a new product is 0.7 and the corresponding probability is 0.3 if the second group wins. If first group wins in the election of board of directors, the probability that it introduces a new product is 0.7. In case of second group is win in this election, that probability of producing a new item is 0.3. In such case, find the probability that new product introduced was by the second group. He knows that a new product was introduced. Once a new product was introduced, what is the probability that was introduced by group 2? Okay. In this case, let G1 event of winning of first group. For the position of board of directors. Okay. G2 stands for event of winning. Go second group. For the position of board of directors. Let H stands for event of introducing new product by winning group. H stands for event of introducing new product by winning group. Now given probability of G1, probability of happening of G1, that means probability of winning the board elections by first group. That was given 0.6, and probability of winning the elections by group 2 is 0.4. If G1 wins, automatically it fails. If G2 wins, it fails. So the sum of the probabilities must be 1 here. And moreover, introducing and probability of introducing the new product by winning the board of directorship, winning the product of directorship by first group, happening of H on the occurrence of or the winning of the first group, that is given. Once the first group wins, introducing probability, new product introducing probability is 0.7. This is 0.7. And the probability of H on the occurrence of G2. In case of the second group wins, it introduces the new product. Such probability is 0.3. Now required probability is once the new product introduced, once we know that a new product is introduced, that was the probability that it was introduced by group 2, second group. So once H happened, happening of G is needed. That means we know that a new product is introduced, given once the new product is introduced, that it was introduced by group 2. The probability is needed, that conditional probability is needed. So this is by definition of conditional probability, probability of G2 intersection H by probability of H, but probability of H is probability of G1 intersection H or probability of G2 intersection H. H may happen either in association with G1 or in association with G2. So H, the total probability of H is obtained by probability of G1 intersection H plus probability of G2 intersection H. This is probability of G2 into probability of H on the occurrence of G2 by probability of G1 into probability of H on the occurrence of G1 plus probability of G2 into probability of H on the occurrence of G2. So these are all the probabilities which gives us the required probability. So here probability of G2 is given 0.4. Corresponding introducing new product by G2 is probability of H and the occurrence of G2 is 0.3. Probability of G1 is 0.6 and corresponding introducing new product probability is 0.7 plus 0.4 into 0.7. This is 12 by 42 plus 12. 12 by 54. 4 threes, oh sorry, this is 6 twos, 6 nines. 2 by 9 is the required probability of G2 on the occurrence of H. That means once a new product is introduced by winning group, that winning group must be second group. That is 2 by 9. Problem 10. Problem number 10. Suppose a girl throws a die. If she gets 5 or 6, she tosses a coin 3 times and notes the number of heads. Once a die is rolled by a person, that means a girl, once she got either 5 or 6 on the die, immediately a coin is tossed 3 times and observes the number of heads on these attempts. If she gets 1, 2, 3, 4 on the die, except 5 or 6, other than number, that number 5 or 6 is observed on the die, either 1, 2 or 4 is observed on the die, rolled die, immediately she tosses the coin only once and notes whether head or tail occurs. If she obtained exactly one head, ultimately she observed or she get exactly one head, what is the probability that she throw 1, 2, 3 or 4 on the die? That is the problem here. Okay. Now, I will define the events. E1 stands for event of getting 5 or 6 on rolled die. E2 stands for event of getting other numbers. Event of getting 1, 2, 3 or 4 on rolled die. Once a die rolled by a girl, either she may get either 5 or 6, or she may get 1, 2, 3, 4. Either even happened or E2 happened once the die is rolled. In case of even happened, she throws a coin 3 times. She throws a coin 3 times. Okay. And observes the number of heads. So let us H, getting of head. H stands for getting of exactly one head. H stands for exactly one head. Once even happened, a coin is tossed 3 times. Given if even happens, a coin is tossed 3 times. If E2 happens, a coin is tossed once only. Okay. In such cases, what is the probability of getting head is needed here? And besides that, once she knows that she found that a head exactly occurred by her, that E2 happens, the probability of E2 happens is needed here. So therefore, probability of even happening of or getting of 5 or 6 on the die. Getting 5 or 6 on the die is 2 by 6, because once a die is rolled, either you may get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Any number may turns up on the die. So the total possibilities are 6. Favorable possibilities are either getting 5 or 6. So 2 by 6. And probability of E2, getting the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4 on the die, rolled die, that is 4 by 6. And probability of happening of H on the occurrence of E1, probability of exactly getting head, one head, on the occurrence of E1 is, once E1 happened, a coin is tossed 3 times, and getting of exactly one head is possible in case of HTT, THT, TTH, hence 3, by total number is 2 cube, that is 2 by 8, since H on the occurrence of even is favorable or HTT, THT, ETH, exactly one head, getting of exactly one head may happen once a coin is tossed 3 times is possible in these cases. So hence I am taking 3, and total number of possible outcomes are 2 cube, that means 8. Okay. Once a coin is tossed, the total number of possible outcomes are 2 cube, because in each attempt, either you may get H or tile. In each attempt, in first attempt, you may get 2 possible outcomes. In second attempt, you may get 2 possible outcomes. In third attempt, you may get 2 possible outcomes. Hence, the total possible outcomes are, in this case, is 2 cube. That is, hence the probability of H on the occurrence of E1 is 3 by 8. and probability of H on the occurrence of E2 is once E2 happens, a coin is tossed once. Hence, probability of getting head in such case is only 1 by 2. Since the favorable possible outcomes is only getting head because it is tossed once. So, with the help of these probabilities, the required probability is probability of happening of E2 on the occurrence of H. Once she knows that she got exactly one head, that then the probability happening of this event is probability of E2 intersection H by probability of H. That is probability of E2 intersection H by probability of H. H may be associated with either E1 or E2. So, you have to consider all the possibilities for getting, for happening of H. So, this is before tossing of the coin, before getting of head, one she tosses the die. So, probability of E2 into probability of H on the occurrence of E2 by this is probability of E1 into probability of H on the occurrence of E1 plus probability of E2 into probability of H on the occurrence of E2 by taking multiplication theorem, you can write the combined events of E2 intersection H or E1 intersection H probabilities like this. Probability of E2 is 4 by 6 and probability of H on the occurrence of E2 is 1 by 2, getting of exactly one head once a coin is tossed, and probability of E1 that is 2 by 6 here, and corresponding probability is getting of head is, that means exactly getting head once if a coin is tossed 3 times, that is 3 by 8. This is 4 by 6 into 1 by 12. The denominators 12 may be cancelled here. So, 4 into 1, 4 by 6 plus 4, 4 by 10, 2 by 5 is required probability. 2 by 5 is the required probability. So, this is the way of applying Bayes' theorem to the problems. Next. A manufacturer has three machine operators. A B C. A machine is operated by three persons. The first operator A produces 1% defective item, whereas the other two operators B and C produce 5% and 7% defective items respectively. The operator A produces 1% defective items and operator B produces 5% defective items and operator C produces 7% defective items. A is on the job for 50% of the time, B is on the job for 30% of the time and C is on the job for 20% of the time. Supposing out of 24 hours, 50% of the time operates and the machine is operated by A. That means 12 hours. For example, per a day of 24 hours, 12 hours is the machine is operated by A, and 30% of the time the machine is operated by B. 30% means out of 24 hours, 30%. And C operates the machine 20% of the time. In such case, a defective item is produced. What is the probability that it was produced by A? What is the probability that the defective item is produced by A? It is given that a defective item is produced. Once a defective item is produced, then what is the probability that it was produced by the operator A? That is the problem. Let E1 stands for this is okay. A operates the machine. Time, selection of time. Produces defective items B 30%. A operate the machine. E2 be the event that B operate the machine. E3 C operate the machine. And D stands for event of selection. A defective item. A defective item produced. Event of selection of a defective item. A defective item produced. Event that a defective item is produced, not selection. It was produced by ABC. So event of producing a defective item. D may happen by A or by B or by C. That means D happens in association with either E1 or E2 or E3. The machine operated by A, and then a defective item may be produced. The machine operated by B, and then a defective item is produced, like that. Now given probability of happening of E1. The probability of operating the machine, the time in a day, the probability of operating the machine by A. This is probability of operating the machine by A. That is 50%. In 50% of that time, that means if in 1 year or 1 month, 50% of time is operated by A, hence 50/100. Probability of operating the machine by B, that is given 30%. Probability of operating the machine by C, probability of E3 is 20%. And probability of producing the defective item by operating the machine A. that is 1%, that is 1 by 100. Probability of producing the defective item by operating the machine B. This is it. This is 5%, 5 by 100. Similarly, probability of producing defective item by operating the machine, the person C. That is 7 by 100. So, this is the probability that if A operates producing of defective item, this is the probability that B operates the machine and producing the defective item, like that. Now, with the help of these probabilities, once he found a defective item is produced, that means D happened, what is the probability that it was produced by the operator A? That means probability of happening of E1 on the occurrence of D is needed. Probability of happening of E1, that means once the machine is operated by A, getting of defective item. It is already known to us, D happened, the defective item is produced. Once it was produced, that it was produced by A probability. That is E1 intersection D by probability of D. But probability of D may be associated either with A1 or E2 or E3. The defective item may be produced by operating the machine by any one of the person. So, here D may be associated with any one of E1, E2, E3. Out of that, we need probability of E1 intersection D, conditional probability. So, that is probability of E1 into probability of D on the occurrence of E1 by probability of E1 into probability of D on the occurrence of E1 plus probability of E2 into probability of D on the occurrence of E2 plus probability of E3 into probability of D on the occurrence of E3. That gives us probability of E1 50 by 100 into correspondingly producing of defective item is 1 by 100 by 50 by 100 into 1 by 100 plus 30 by 100 into corresponding producing defective item is 5 by 100 plus 20 by 100 into corresponding producing of defective item is 7 by 100. So, the required probability is 50 by simplification, the denominators may cancel, 50 by 50 plus 30 into 5, 150, 7 into 20, 140, that is 5 by 5 plus 15 plus 14, this is 5 by 34, 5 by 34. This is the required probability that a defective item is produced, that was produced by A. Once we know that the item produced is defective, then the probability that it was produced by the operator A, that is the required probability. Problem number 12. A card from a pack of 52 cards A card from pack of 52 cards is lost, is missed. From the remaining cards of pack, two cards are drawn and are found to be both diamonds. Find the probability that the missing card being a diamond. The lost card is a diamond. Okay. A card is missed from a pack of cards of 52 well shuffled packs, from a deck of packs, pack of cards, a card is missed. So the missing card may be